Oh, thank you for tuning in to this program. Oh, I love putting together these variety programs for you. Enjoy the show.
How are you doing today? I need to tell you some things about me and, yeah, or other things than just that, but this video is all about 1% in particular. I have more videos like this, but that'll be in the future. But right now, I need to talk about some female that I like. Well, you know what I mean. Well, she's pretty.
Hey you guys, welcome back. I haven't made a video in a very long time. I'm so sorry, but let me just say my life has been a nightmare lately, and I'm gonna share about that, what just all the crazy that's going on at the end of this video. So if you want to see my giant pity party, stay tuned to the end of that.
So it's important for people who don't necessarily get regular health care to eat really well. This is why Kendra and I grow a lot of our own food organically. Millions of Americans don't have any kind of health insurance, and millions more have health insurance that's so bad, with deductibles that are so high, that they can't access health insurance.
I prefer the hamburger. And I think this is the regular burger with cheese in it. And I don't think their French fries are any better than that. That's a very pale, limp French fry, isn't it? I mean, it doesn't look like the kind I would want to eat.
The easiest way to find your cleaning and organizing mojo is to do a quick purge, to feel that urge to purge. Getting rid of things does not have to be hard. What I recommend doing first is a little garbage bag therapy. Grab a garbage bag, run around your house, and just look for garbage. Receipts you don't need anymore, empty boxes perhaps. There's always going to be those scrap pieces of paper or, you know, junk mail laying around, things you don't even have to think twice about. Run around your house and do a little trash bag tango, as Peter Walsh would call it, or a little garbage bag therapy, and just get rid of things. It feels so good, and not only that, it's super motivating.
I hope you like what you see. But let's show you what that means in acceleration. So one thing that we care about Tesla is we really care about performance. We want a vehicle that feels incredible, that accelerates like nothing else. Let's show what the truck, what it's like to be in a Tesla truck. This is real time. So that's the Tesla Semi will go 0 to 60 in 5 seconds. So that's by itself or with a trailer. Now at 80,000 pounds max gross vehicle weight, that's the most amount of weight you can carry on a US highway. This is the real-time acceleration of a Tesla Semi. That on the left, the thing that looks like it's not moving is a diesel truck. Just gonna give it a moment. I'm sorry to bore you. I apologize. It's boring. I know. Eventually it'll get there. All right. Even with 80,000 pounds pulling max gross, getting 60 miles an hour in 20 seconds. That's what it can do. Now, what about up a hill? Okay. The best diesel trucks can only do 45 miles an hour up a 5% grade. Tesla Semi can do 65 miles an hour up a 5% grade.
So in no time at all, I was able to fill almost an entire garbage bag filled with just garbage from my home.
Well, Scotty the Body, things didn't go too well for you and your girlfriend out there, did it?
Hey, it went real good, Koss. Let me tell you something. It was a wonderful, glorious 1989 for Scotty the Body. I am the Pacific Northwest Heavyweight Champion. I have not lost my title for the 6 months I've held it so far. As a matter of fact, last week, I turned back the stiffest challenger there is, Rip the Crippler Oliver, and 1990 promises to be an even bigger year. Earlier this evening, you people at home missed it. Me and my girl Veronica, we smashed that bimbo ginger, the really ugly one. Her and Steve Dahl, we smashed them. But I tell you what, you know what made it feel so good, that victory? It felt so good because she was the bimbo I left at the altar. I dumped her at the altar. I made a jump out of her in 89. I made a jump out of her in 90. I'm going to make a jump out of her in 91. Hey, you can't stop me. Nobody can stop me, cause I'm too cool.
Oh, you're... Well, why don't you tell it to this lady right here? Ginger, did you hear all this stuff he's saying?
Yeah, I did. You didn't kick anybody's butt. You took off with a bunch of cowards. And you know what? I'm about sick of you and your little bimbo friends. You stood me up at the altar. You hurt me. You embarrassed me. I'm tired of it. I'm not finished with her yet. And I've got something for you, too, right now.
Oh, careful.
Whoa! Holy mackerel! Hey, listen. All right, just cool it.
This is not the ring. Veronica, what are you doing? Oh, come on. Look at the eggs all over Ginger's hair, all over her face. Come on.
Shut up, Puss. Get out of my way.
Hey.
That's what she deserves, that chicken. She lost that match. We won it fair and square.
Oh, you...
Yolks on her.
Oh, that's real cute. Let's get out of here. We'll be right back right after this.
Yeah. And what they're beginning to find is that the weather and the toxicity of our planet right now is creating something called pro-inflammatory cytokines. And what pro-inflammatory cytokines do is they actually create the feeling of malaise, the feeling of disease.
Action Booker steps in the ring and Gorilla Monsoon. This is one of the most insidious individuals I've ever seen. Oh, isn't he a handsome son of a gun here on Father's Day? 401 pounds.
While San Antonio is certainly drawing big tourism numbers each and every year, there's also something else that it's a magnet for, the homeless. But city leaders believe they have partially solved that big problem. The answer lies here at Haven for Hope, a 37-acre, $100 million homeless facility billed as the largest facility of its kind in the entire country. It opened in 2010 and offers everything from medical care to job training. It's a one-stop shop where the homeless can start to turn their lives around.
Had Haven for Hope not opened, I would be living a life of misery, addicted to methamphetamines, living on the streets of San Antonio.
Samuel Lott says he'd been on a downward spiral after losing his contracting job with the railroad. He began to drink heavily and do drugs. He was down and out and knew he needed help. And that's when he found out about this place.
Lay your hand on me.
I got a lot of my life back, and it's not getting my life back. I got a new life. That's what's starting to happen here.
Now, Lott works at Haven for Hope, sharing his experience with those who are trying to straighten out their own lives.
I think something like this can be tried in any city. And what's great about Haven for Hope and the whole model that we have here is that it's scalable.
I want to basically, when I get enough money one day, I would give every school maybe $2 million for the academics and for the school arts and everything. Because I want to help out every school. Like, they literally need help, so and I don't want them to lose the arts or the academics in the future, so I'll basically help out. I want to try to help out a lot of schools in the future, help out my friends and everybody in general that needs it, you know, because I have a lot of friends and a lot of, yeah. A lot of people I went to school with that are teachers in different schools, or they, or coaches, or like other staff members for schools in general. Like they actually teaching and are principals or something like that. Like, I don't know. I'm gonna help out every single one of them because reality is I want to help out every school now, man. Basically, I am going to pay $1 million to $2 million when I get enough money one day to that schools. I mean, in the future, it ain't gonna happen right now, but in the future, it will happen. So anyway, if anybody's watching this video, help me get this out because we need to help out every school, man. Because I like all these schools and all these schools helped me out, and then I had a lot of friends and a lot of people that are also teaching and or coaches or something like that. Like, literally, a lot of them are like coaches now in football, soccer, track, cross country, blah, blah, blah. Like, they're also, blah, 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 blah. I mean, like, the coaches for every sport, okay? Let's do that. And then you got a lot of them are also teaching in school, too. Or teaching, or like teachers in schools. And then you got people trying to be also drama club teachers and music teachers and band teachers and other stuff. I'm just gonna say this. I want to help out the whole entire school of every school. Basically, what I'm trying to say is, in the future, I am going to do that. I might even send it to them in person. But anyway, like I said, man, that'll be in the future, though. As right now, I'm going to say, anybody out there who would like to help out all these schools, go ahead and do that. Like, give them how much money you can give them, you know? You don't have to give them too many, you don't have to give them a lot of money, but you can give them as much money to help them out, you know, with the schools, you know? Basically, be there to help them out, you know? I'm not saying to actually give them a lot of money, but anyway, I just like to see all the schools keep going because we need schools to so they can teach all these kids and all the newer kids and other crap, you know? Yeah. Anyway, guys, I'm not going to end this video yet, but it would be awesome to see the academics and the arts and all of that crap get a lot of money just so it can so we can support them, you know? Support the school, support system, support every single one of them, because not all my bad. I mean, not everyone is bad, let's just say that.
Thank you guys so much who have stayed to the end. Here's my pity party. So I have pneumonia. I'm almost over it, but not quite. Last week I had pneumonia after 2 weeks of like a sinus, you know, cold that turned into an infection that turned into pneumonia. And on Friday, Milo had his tonsils out. And Saturday night, he had a crazy high fever. It was like 41 and he was having rigors. So he was having like convulsion shakes. So at 2 a.m, I rushed him to the ER, to the emergency room. And we were there till like all night. And there was no chair, it was just me standing. I was so tired. By, I think, noon the next day, we were admitted to the pediatrics ward. And by this point, he was just hysterical. We had some traumatic things with them trying to get IVs in, and they couldn't, and his veins kept collapsing, and he was screaming. And at one point, I don't know what happened, but blood was like shooting from him. And I was crying, he was crying. They couldn't get an IV on. They tried, I think, 10 different places to put it in and held him down, wrapped him up really, really tight. They had like a paramedic laying on him and someone holding his legs down, someone holding his head still, and he was screaming for like a long time. Like, we're saying maybe 15 minutes to half an hour of just them pinning him down, poking him in different spots, and it was horrifying.
Maybe it would be a sensible weight loss program to eat nothing.
Oh, wasn't that random though? This has been Sal Hennig. Thank you for tuning in and watching our show.